Hi, I'm going to show you how to install Git onto your PC. So Git is a version control program for saving the changes you want to make to files over time, which is useful to track changes on your projects, but it's even more useful when working with a team. And in the last couple chapters of this course, we're going to be using Git to save data and your notebooks to GitHub or GitLab. We're going to be following the process that Ben Walsh has described on the site at firstpythonnotebook.org. So the step to do this is right here in this notepad. So first thing we need to do is check if we already have Git installed. And to do that, we just need to go to command, which is down here under search, type in cmd. And it's the first thing that'll pop up, click on that, and type in what's here, git --version. And what we get is Git is not recognized as an internal or external command. That means it's not installed yet. So we can go to this website, git-4-windows.github.io, and I already have that set up on this browser. Click download, and I already have it downloaded, so I'm just going to click on open. Unzip it, run the exe file. Click run. You're going to need administrative privileges for this, by the way. Loading. Click yes. Yes to allow changes. Yes. Click all the defaults. Next. All the defaults, go ahead. Now while that loads, after this is done, we're going to go back to terminal, the command, to see if it installed correctly. And then we're going to set up our identity. Here we go. Completed. Done. Well, I might have double-clicked it twice. So let's just see if it worked. I'm going to type in git --version. Still nothing. Maybe if I... Oh. I have to close down command and open it again, kind of restart it. So type in command, cmd, and let's try it again. git --version. And there we go. Now it works. Git version 2.17.1. Okay, next. Set up our identity. Close this because I don't need to install it again. And type in git config --global user.email. And that's your email, followed by git config --global user.name, and then your name. That's it. You are ready to proceed and get to that last chapter where we'll move on to GitHub and Git.